Ammunition. There is so much of it in so little time. But in this video, I'm going to cover some of the basic, most common used type of ammo out there. This is the Urban Sentinel. Let's get into it. Ammunition. You can never have too much ammunition. That is the absolute truth. But what type of ammunition do you need? What's the best type of ammunition to use? That's the question. This video, I'm going to go over some of the similarities and differences of some of the more popular caliber type ammunition out there. The two most common types are rimfire and centerfire. The primary difference, if you look at the back of the centerfire, there is a primer. On the rimfire, within the interior of that rim are the chemicals for the primer. So this is a 22 long rifle, 22LR. It is a rimfire. The chemicals inside that rim, when struck by the pin, detonate the powder and expel the bullet. Whereas here, the primer, that little center dot in the back, when that is hit by the firing pin, that explodes, detonating the powder and then expelling the bullet that way. Overall, those are the two types of bullets that pretty much cartridges that you're going to find anywhere. The rimfire, by and large, is a very popular type cartridge. It's inexpensive. You can pretty much, you know, dime a dozen, as they say, but you can get a lot of 22LR for very little money. Centerfire cartridges, they range. It depends upon the actual caliber, the popularity of it, the cost to manufacture of it, because they come in a much larger size variety of available cartridges. Now, another distinction between different types of bullets, you'll hear terms like FMJ, which stands for full metal jacket, and you might hear HP, also standing for hollow point. Those two key things look like this. The full metal jacket is effectively a lead bullet, usually encased in copper. It's smooth, it's round. It's also referred to as ball ammunition because it does have a very similar profile to effectively a ball, a sphere, even though it is not spherical in its actual design. Hollow point is any type of bullet with a hollow cavity in the top. It can vary depending upon the type of bullet. These two cartridges, this is a 38 special. This is a 357 Magnum. Both are very close in their measurements, but any handgun that is designed to fire the 357 Magnum can also fire the 38 Special, but not the other way around. If you have a handgun that is designed for 38 Special, you can load in a 357 Magnum. The end results will be, if you're lucky, it'll damage the firearm, nothing more. If you're unlucky, it'll destroy the firearm, damage and injure you as well. The reason being is the amount of powder and pressure that the 357 Magnum generates is greater than what the 38 Special generates. And firearms, when they're designed as mechanical devices to withstand a certain amount of pressure. If you put a higher pressure cartridge into a firearm that's designed for a lower pressure cartridge, you can have metal fatigue, you can damage the parts that are inside, you can completely obliterate the firearm, and of course, when you have that type of explosion, your hand is most likely in immediate contact with it, and since your hand can only go as far as the length of your arm, there's a greater possibility that your hand, your arm, and your face could also be injured as well. Different types of cartridges can be used for different types of firearms and have different purposes. Yes, there are cartridges that are better designed for hunting than there are for self-defense, and there are different types of self-defense cartridges even within that same category. understanding that not every cartridge, even if it fits the firearm that it is designed for, is not necessarily the optimum cartridge for the purpose that you're going to use it. Now, make no mistake, all bullets can kill. All bullets can injure. It doesn't matter what type of caliber it is. It could be a 22, it could be a 223, it could be a 308. It doesn't matter. All bullets can kill. But in the determination of what you're going to be using the firearm for, having the right type of ammunition for that firearm is what is the important factor that you need to look at. So going through these real quick. The 22, there are handguns and rifles that fire this. It's good for practice, especially good for what you'll hear the term plinking, for people who are just shooting recreationally, getting accustomed to shooting a firearm. The 22 is an inexpensive way to practice and just get familiar with firearm use. The 38 Special and the 357 Magnum. Predominantly, these will be found in revolver handguns. There are a few semi-automatic handguns that will fire 357 Magnum, but by and large, these are the types of cartridges used in effectively thinking about the six shooters. The 9x19mm and the 9x17mm. Now, if you're thinking, what are those? This is what is most commonly referred to and known as a 9mm. That's its measurement. This is predominantly known as the 380. That's the American measurement or imperial standard. The reason why this is a 9x17 and this is a 9x19, the length of the casing is part of its actual measured designation. Both bullets are the same diameter, but the casing is a different length. And again, you may be able to fit this 380 into a firearm that fires 9mm. The pressure is going to be lower, which that also causes problems when it comes to feeding. So you only want to use the appropriate ammunition, regardless of if it fits in the appropriate firearm. .223 and .556. Their measurements are almost imperceptible. It's really coming down to looking at the length of the neck on the casing. But again, a firearm that is designed to fire 5.56 can also fire 223, but you run the risk of damaging the firearm and getting injured if you reverse those cartridges. These are both shotgun shells. This is a 410 gauge shotgun shell, and this is a 12 gauge shotgun shell. 12 gauge shotgun shell, by and large, is the most popular gauge for shotguns, I will say definitely in America. This one here, you can find shotguns that are designed to fire 410, and there are also a few handguns, of which I own one, that will also fire a 410 gauge shot shell. 12 gauge comes in numerous size pellets, depending upon what you're looking at. This is a double odd buck shot shell. And again, knowing that the designation of the caliber is based upon the measurement, the diameter of the bullet, these are all 45 caliber. The primary difference is this is 45 ACP, known as auto coat pistol. This is 45 Colt. And this is a 45-70. You can clearly see three different sized cases, three different amounts of powder, three different end results of use. But all of them are 45 caliber. Now, as I said, different types of bullet heads will have different end results. This is a solid lead casted bullet. This has a lead core with a copper jacket. This full metal jacket FMJ and this lead flat tip both, when they impact a target, more or less flatten out kind of in a mushroom type shape as they pass into and through the target. Whereas something with a hollow point, although this one is lead, and this one has also a copper jacketing on it, they would expand. This soft hollow point is going to open up a little bit wider, but it will still deform as it moves through the target. Whereas this one with the jacket copper, the copper jacket, will open up into a semi, almost a pedal sawtooth style format as it moves through the target. The primary things you need to consider is, I'm doing this video based upon the use of ammunition in firearms for self-defense. So first and foremost, soft lead tip ammunition, yes, you can use it for self-defense. It will still injure, it will still kill. It is effective, but not as effective as ammunition specifically designed for self-defense. Also, on the cost aspect of it, soft lead ammunition is much better used for the shooting range and practicing. Now, many of the things you'll hear are terms in relation to the firearms. It's not the firearm itself. It is the actual cartridge, the bullet that comes out of it. You hear things of velocity as an example. So as an example, this .223, when fired from an 18-inch barrel rifle, the bullet is traveling at a very high rate, several hundred feet per second, in direct comparison to this 9mm coming out of a 3.5-inch barrel from a handgun. It's still traveling fast, but not nearly as fast as the .223. But to put it into perspective, if you had two shooters facing off against each other 100 feet apart, and both of them had exactly the same amount of time to draw, aim, and fire their weapon at the other person at the exact same time, no one between those two would know it. Why? Because at distances of less than 100 yards, the speed difference between that example of the .223 rifle cartridge and the 9mm handgun cartridge is infinitely immeasurable. It is 0.00001th to a measurement. You won't know. When you're shooting a rifle at 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 yards, you can measure out the time it takes it to travel, and you can measure out the time it takes that 9mm to travel. And yes, the .223 will travel faster. But the reality is, in a situation like that, as an example, if you did have two people shooting at each other at that close distance of 100, even 200 feet away, and they both pulled the trigger at the same time, and they both effectively got center of mass shots, both would be down and dead on the ground and not know if they got the other person, because both bullets at that short of a distance are traveling so fast that effectively you're never going to be able to measure that time difference between the person getting hit by the .223 and the person getting hit by the 9mm, because they're both going to be dead like that. Now, this is a .22. And this is a .22. Yes, clearly there's a size difference in the overall cartridge, but again, remember, the designation is about the diameter of the bullet. So they're both the same diameter. One just simply has a lot more powder in it in direct comparison to the other. Two things to take into consideration when selecting the type of caliber and ammunition: stopping power and shot placement. Stopping power does have a purpose with ammunition, because the stopping power of, as an example, this .22, in direct comparison to the stopping power of this .45-70, it is a wide chasm of difference. But shot placement also has a lot to do with it. Shot placement of a .22 into the right section of soft tissue, into the right part of the body, one shot could effectively kill a person. Whereas shot placement, yes, with one of these would also have the same effect, but a poorly placed shot can also leave that person that you're trying to stop from harming you still active and still functional. But again, the range difference between the two is to one extent subjective, based upon also to the physical capability and determination of the person attacking you. One of the best things and easiest things that you can do is get to a shooting range. Get to a shooting range that has firearms for use at the range. If you know people that own different types of firearms, ask if you can go to the range with them and you can learn. Because getting your hands on a firearm, shooting different types of calibers, makes it easier for you to get a better understanding of the type of firearm that you might be able to handle in a self-defense situation, because that's the primary focus. Yes, practicing and getting to the targets and shooting at the range are necessary. It's something that should be done on a regular basis because it is a deteriorating skill. You may have the knowledge of how the firearm works and the things you're supposed to do, but when you don't physically practice them, just like a lot of things, the skill wears off. You may be able to pick it back up again if you've been a person who's been doing a lot of shooting in the past, but your skills do dull and they do start to wear down the less you do it. So getting practice on a regular basis is something that will help. And also for new shooters, getting practice gives you confidence that you understand the process, that you actually know the actual steps that you're doing, because there are plenty of people that can read about it, they can watch a video about it and say, I know all I need to know. But until you get your hands on the trigger and you start shooting, you're not going to fully understand how you physically are going to respond and react, how your body responds and reacts to shooting the gun, how you mentally handle that situation. So, speeding this whole thing up, go out, get firearms training, get a better understanding of the difference between different types of firearms and the things that they can do and can't do. That's the primary thing. And it all comes down to the type of ammunition that that firearm uses. I'll put a card up here or at the end screen to the other videos in this series, and I'll catch you in the next one.